This is TWiT.
What does SE stand for? Nothing. Nothing.
They claim nothing.
Nothing.
They claim it doesn't stand for anything.
Microsoft announced yet another version of Windows.
It's got to be student edition.
School edition or student
school edition.
Is it Windows S? Is it?
No. Not S mode. Nope.
No, Microsoft made fun of S mode as part of this introduction.
They did.
You see that in the fact? Yeah.
No.
They were like, oh, S mode. I don't know what we were thinking then.
Really?
That was just.
What? Really?
But they keep selling it still. Like, they ship some devices with S mode, even with Windows 11, right?
All that does is limit it. No, that's dumb. Why would you even use that?
I don't
Microsoft
know.
Microsoft says.
So, yeah, SE is, I mean, it is the student edition, right? It's for school, right? It's to compete with Chromebook, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. A word they never used, unsurprisingly, in announcing this.
Yeah. Yeah. What they should
know,
be doing is side by side. Here are the costs. Here's the complexity. Here's the whatever.
Yeah.
And that's how you sell something like that.
They used to do that. Remember those Pawn Star ads where they would make fun of a Chromebook? And
yeah, but Leo, you know what happened since then?
Yeah.
This is the problem. Chromebooks got really good.
Yeah.
So Chromebooks work offline. There's all this stuff, you know, these like myths about Chromebooks that people try to spread that aren't true anymore. And it's like, actually, guys, I hate to break it to you, but Chrome OS works much better on low-end hardware than Windows does. Of course it does. It's a simpler, smaller OS, you know?
Yeah.
So did they announce new hardware to go with SE?
Yeah, they did both, right? So they did. They announced Windows 11 SE, and then they said, we have a lot of partners who are going to make these low-end PCs for the education market and install this on it. And we're going to make one too, Surface Laptop SE.
By the way, let me ask you about that, Mary Jo.
I know what you're going to ask. I know what you're going to ask me.
Okay.
You're going to say why.
Well, why? So, for example, what can Microsoft introduce into this ecosystem that would benefit everybody, right? Obviously, a low resources version of Windows that runs on low-end hardware well. Okay, got it. Up against Chrome OS. Some type of low, inexpensive, and easy-to-use deployment, management, configuration software, or service, rather, in the cloud. Mm-hmm. That matches what Google gives or provides to schools, right? Those are the investments Microsoft makes. Mm-hmm. We already have 10 companies or 15 companies or whatever it is making little $250 pieces of junk that have Celeron processors, 4 gigs of RAM, eMCC storage, and my God, a 1366 by 768, 16 by 9 display. What did you get that like out of a Dell yard sale from 8 years ago?
And which is not a touchscreen, of course, right?
Of course not.
Unlike every other Surface.
But that's the market. Like, we get it, right? The education cash trap is fine. Why on earth would Microsoft tarnish the Surface brand by getting rid of everything that makes Surface a Surface, except for the keyboard, apparently, and selling yet another piece of junk for $250? Why? What is the justification for this?
Why?
Yeah. No,
I don't think I don't think they said why. I mean, the justification they give in the blog post is basically because we're Microsoft and we could design the hardware with the software with the services. The experience is going to be great because we have the teams doing all of them, right? But that kind of flies in the face of them having OEMs, right?
Right.
Where, hey, you're not supposed to have an advantage if you're the Surface team over at Dell and HP and Lenovo, right? Because
Microsoft,
Windows is supposed to be for everybody.
Right. Well, right. And Surface PCs have had consistently since Surface Pro 3, have had 3x2 displays, the same exact PPI, I believe, on almost every single one of them, meaning, you know, pixels per inch. Surface Connect port for power, right? And this thing, and then they're made out of premium materials and all that kind of stuff. We understand an education laptop's not going to be a premium device. Although, by the way, 4 years ago, they tried to sell you one of those, right? That's remember they announced Surface Laptop, the original, at their previous, I think there was their previous education event.
It was.
So this thing is, it's a Surface So it's a Surface in name only. You know, it's just another plastic computer. I will say the one innovation here, and this is something they should apply to everything they make, is this thing is incredibly serviceable. Right. You can easily take off the bottom. You can access all the components. You can swap out everything in this, including the entire motherboard.
You have to do that if you're going to sell this to schools.
For schools.
Plus, also IT, like they call it zero touch deployment, right? So, you have to do that for schools.
But what does Microsoft's zero touch deployment and Intune based management capabilities cost? And how hard is it to use compared to what Google offers for Chromebooks? I don't know. Right. I mean, that's not really a rhetorical question. I actually don't know.
So, you know what's funny? As usual at these Microsoft events, we read the blog posts. We got a pre-brief on this. And there were a lot of details that we weren't told until the FAQ came out on this stuff. And then we learned a lot of things we didn't know going into the announcement. One of those is... Intune for Education is a requirement for these devices. It's not optional. You can't use a third-party product instead of it. You have to use Windows.
They must have introduced a new lower-cost tier of Intune for Education.
They did, which is, I don't know if you all remember this, but on Windows Weekly a few weeks ago, I was talking about this SKU that Microsoft introduced for Microsoft 365 A1 per device. And they introduced this a little earlier than this announcement, and nobody could figure out who this was for or what this was. There were like no details on it except the price, $38 per device for a period of up to 6 years, which is great. Okay. But then everybody in education was like, who is this for though? Like who would use this? Well, it turns out this is what this is for, right? And this SKU, I believe, this new Microsoft 365 A1 per device includes Windows 11 SE. It includes Intune for Education. It includes all the Office apps that can be downloaded locally. Okay. Right. So it's a really cheap way to get this to students.
So I used to be on the board of a school that did a one-to-one laptop program, and they were spending $1,000 per laptop. So this is pretty compelling.
This is K through 8, by the way, to be clear. This is not high school.
Is that because it's not powerful enough?
I'm sure that's part of it. I think they also want to wrap up the price for, you know.
This is a little confusing. The software they advertise as being for K through 12 and the laptop K through 8.
Okay.
I was looking at it. I'm like, wait. Nope, they don't match. Okay, cool.
Did either of you get to play with this hardware at all?
No.
I
don't have a problem with the K-8 thing. It's fair to say that someone that age is going to have much lower end needs than someone who's in high school. That's absolutely fine. And once you're in high school, you pretty much need a real computer. That's okay. That's fine. But so does Microsoft offer educational institutions a way to spread these costs out over the lifetime of the device or something? You know, they have Surface Complete where it's something like that, where you pay them monthly or something for the entire fleet of stuff. Or
I don't know about that. Here's what I do know. Education volume discounts are massive, right? Like when you're talking like, hey, we have a school system of like 500,000 people. They want that business, right? Like you're going to get a great price from Microsoft on that.
Yep.